This is Norton Wayne speaking of 1G Hyde Park Mansions, London, NW1. Telephone Paddington 9704. I'm not a Londoner by birth, however. I was born in a little village in South Wales called Pontypridd. I don't think it's there now. Population was always decreasing. Every time a child was born, 6 young men used to leave the village. I left quite early, and I became an entertainer. Not the usual sort of entertainer. I mean, the average entertainer is a real comedian who pretends to be a silly ass, and I, on the other hand, am a real silly ass who pretends to be a comedian. So I have to have a lady secretary to attend to my correspondence. Matter of fact, she's here with me now. Miss Flukenpush, we better attend to this fan mail. First letter reads, Dear Sir, I, being a gentleman, cannot tell you what I think of your performance. My secretary, being a lady, cannot write it. You, being neither, can guess it all. Was hardly any need to reply to that. Oh, the second letter here is not a fan letter at all. It's a letter from my tailor. He says, Sir, man is dust. Dust settles. Be a man. Well, we'd better tell him exactly how I settle my accounts. Sir, every month I make a pile of my accounts on a desk, and 6 of these I select at random. These I pay. If I have any more of your damned impudence, you won't be in the shuffle at all next month. This letter here contains a brochure. It says, Dear Sir, we herewith have pleasure in sending you particulars of our new mental home, trusting to be favored with your patronage at an early date. We won't reply to that yet. This is rather serious. This one. Sir, I understand that during the time I've been abroad, you've been fooling around with my wife. If you'll kindly call at my office at 11:30 on Wednesday, I should be glad if you'll give me an explanation. We'll reply to this. Sir, I thank you for your circular, and I shall be pleased to attend the meeting of the shareholders as you desire. Here's a nice one in a lady's hand. Dear sir, I wonder if, in addition to your other work, you ever entertain at private parties. And if so, will you kindly tell me what your fee would be? Well, Dear madam, thank you for your letter. I do entertain at private parties, and my fee would be 50 guineas. Oh, just a second. You've got a P.S. here. Please understand that we do not want you to mix with the guests. Well, in that case, tell her that the fee would be only 25 guineas. Thank you. I think I ought to explain that the typist you hear so busily working is not a professional secretary at all. She's a lady friend of mine who's doing it in an entirely voluntary capacity. She's really a very, very nice girl. She's a photographer's daughter. Underdeveloped, overexposed, and fond of a dark room. Awfully nice girl. I met her at a nightclub, and I went straight up to her. I said, may I have the next dance? And she said, certainly, if you can find a partner. Awfully nice. So I apologized. I said, I'm awfully sorry, I'm not dancing very well tonight, because I'm a little stiff from tennis. And she said, I don't care where you come from. She really is a charming girl. So I asked her if she was hungry, and she said she could do with a bite, so I gave her one. And during the meal, she told me all about herself. Apparently, she earns her own living and spends all that she earns on dress. I don't think she can earn very much, because her clothes rather remind one of barbed wire. You know, they protect the property without obstructing the view. Awfully nice clothes. She's in the theatrical profession, really. She was one of the Hip Hip Hooray girls. In that show, she used to get £7.10 a week. £5 for the hips and £2.10 for the hoorays. Very nice girl. But although she's in the theatrical profession, her people are very, very strict with her all the same. And they always expect her to be into breakfast. And I was so taken with the girl that I proposed to her on the spur of the moment, being frightfully impulsive. And she said she was very sorry she couldn't marry me because she had some clause in her contract. So I said, that doesn't matter at all. My father is a surgeon. But she didn't take any notice. Then I asked her if she'd like to come to one of these new ice rinks that they've got in London. And she said she'd love to. So I took her along there. No good. Couldn't skate. She sat down 12 times in 5 minutes and said it was spoiling her fun. I said, don't be silly. Nothing will spoil if it's kept on ice. And then I said, may I see you home by taxi? She said, no, she's afraid of accidents. So I said, well, here, I'll tell the man to be very careful. Told the man to be careful. We had an accident just the same. Because suddenly, the taxi pulled up with a jerk. So I put my head through the window, having lowered the window first. And I said to the chap, what's the trouble? And he said, well, the lady inside shouted, stop. I said, you carry on. She wasn't speaking to you.